Welcome everybody to this new conference, Unfolding the Technique. I'm very pleased today to have online Florian Troll, Director of Innovation, Apparel Design Team at Salomon, but also curator of the exhibition, the new exhibition in La Cité du Design, and I'm sure he will present it to you. So Florian, please, the floor is yours. And just, sorry, I forgot to everybody, please do not hesitate to write your questions in the chat. I'd be happy to read them at the end of the presentation. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. I have the chance to participate to the curation of the exhibition for the next Biennale du Design in 21 next year, and the topic of the Biennale will be in France, how do we change direction regarding the way we are doing products, the way French companies are looking for a safer business regarding the environment, and also the concern of the consumer. What do they really want, and how can we have a fair answer to their wants? This exhibition is in this French context of the Cité du Design. This Biennale happens once every 2 years, and it's been years that I'm following each Biennale with a great pleasure. It's a very wonderful place if you can visit it, very creative and inspiring. And the people from the Cité du Design invite me to participate this year, and this is the first time for me. I'm super happy to participate. I've been looking for the right object to display during the lockdown. Was not previous for sure, and as a lot of us, I was a bit nervous during this period, trying to figure out how it will restart and how the business will be after this period. And it was a very special times where the idea were exploding, and we had very good moment of discussion with the people from the Cité du Design, trying to find the best company, the ones who were the more advanced in the use of new materials, in the new process also, and a lot of very good discussion together. And by my side, I brought a lot of fabric sensitivity, apparel sensitivity, because it's been years that I've been working in this environment. I started 25 years ago to practice design in Jean-Paul Gaultier design studio in Paris, where he was shifting already from haute couture to ready-to-wear. And I was in charge to do graphics for the new ready-to-wear brand, JPG, and where I understood that from France, production and haute couture, Gaultier was looking for another kind of business, and he had to realize stuff in Italy to have a greater meaning and a better look. At Michelin, I had the opportunity to work with different people, understanding the importance of performance in design, and also understanding how business could be driven by the global warming today in many kind of industry, especially tires and winter tires. But I won't explain too much about that right now. And finally, It's been 20 years I'm working at Salomon with several top athletes, but also with people enjoying doing sports every day and looking for the lightest gear and the more reliant and secure gear. So, and focusing on body performance and apparel and gear soft goods. That can explain why I choose to treat or to collect objects around the body and the relationship of those objects more intimate or more show off to protect or hide the body. And we could visit this exhibition in following four different sections. The first section will be the feeding, the way we feed our body and how design interact in that. Then we will have a section discussing about the way we dress, the way we move in the city or in the nature, and the way we care about our body. And I don't know if I really clearly mentioned it, but the exhibition will be about the changes to come and how the designer will treat these changes. So in the feeding section, I won't go too much into detail, but you will discover two sides. First, more important topic will be hydration. How do we hydrate? And I think that the water will be a very big concern in the coming years. How do we provide clean and clear water to every population? How do we collect the water coming from the rain, for instance, and how can we use this water? But also, how can we travel with liquids? How can we make a safe protection of the liquids? And the second part of this section will be cooking instrument, cooking places, and also how do we pack the food? With a reduction of plastics, how do we find other way to protect food? The dressing section will be more or less how high fashion influence the way we dress every day, knowing that a lot of young consumers are moving today, selecting a lot of second-hand garment apparel because they do prefer high-quality stuff, more durable stuff. So how the fashion industry, from high-end to everyday ready-to-wear, is telling us how to dress ourselves, influencing, but also taking care of materials, transportation, because for sure it's not a very clean industry today. There is a lot of waste, a lot of different very important matter, especially if you look in the outdoor industry, but we will discuss that when we will come to Salomon. The moving section first will happen in the city. What are the companies which are proposing a new way to behave in the city, how to move in the city in a safer and make the city a safer and a cleaner environment? So that will be the thematic of this section. And the next session will be more the outdoor, how we move in nature, first in the mountain, then on the sea, in the sea, above the sea. What are the new materials, more natural, more clean for the earth. Also, the new way to use some biomimicry, and how designers can find a new inspiration to create their collections. In the care section, would be the last part of the exhibition. We will focus on two sides. First is when we cannot move, when we are in the hospital, for instance, and when we move, when we are working, and how can we find our mobility back with prostheses or some exoskeleton. That will be the kind of object we will display. So you have here the first draft of the exhibition, knowing that we have a lot of talk to run again to build this exhibition, but we will go in the four different sections, as I told you: feeding, dressing, moving and carrying, and trying to have this constant look on project, object, around the body, and also now in the coming weeks I will contact each designer of each of those objects to ask them why did they try to execute product in a different way. Is that a business issue? Is that a consumer request? And how, which technique they use to find a new process? And what was the real role of the designer in this bifurcation? And third question will be, at the end of the day, what is the result, social, ecological, economic, what is the follow-up of the project? And we will address first on these eight masters those questions, but on the 35 company that we will contact, we will address the same question and try to run into this discussion. So I will shortly present you. So one of the master will be the Suez company providing water, and I will contact them and trying to understand how do they use this new software, where you can have Wi-Fi connection to have a direct understanding of the quality of water, a live analysis, and to see if there is any defect in the way we provide water in the cities, and how to find the best quality of water. The second master will be this rain collector coming from the Faltasi company, where they kind of collect water to deliver for the gardening, and you can branch this collector in any kind of building in the cities. Gauthier will for sure bring a lot of craziness and inspiration from high-end couture, but it's also his last catwalk and the rebirth of his brand by collaborating with a new Japanese designer. So maybe we can display how the change will happen in this world, and how the iconic designer can rebirth through the styles of another one, younger one, designer. And Micheline, for sure, is one of my ex-company, and I will have great pleasure to discuss with the team who built this wonderful visionary project in 2017. A very interesting project of a tire with no hair, addressing at least four big topic and very interesting problem to solve. Is the first one is using material easy to recycle or to this should be a tire wheel made out of natural material or recycled material, combining a very interesting process of 3D printing to do the full product. So this is one big issue with actual tires, where the recycling part of it is not really taken in consideration, and the usage create a lot of waste today in the tire industry. So this is a big step forward. Another aspect of this project is it's a tire with no air, so no problem to explode or being flat with this tire. So very interesting. Another way is it's an adaptive tire to a different kind of ground, because the tread pattern can be printed in some station, 3D print station. So that means that anywhere you go, you can print the patent you will need. If you go in snow, if you go in sand, if you go on highway or on streets, and so it can enhance the life of your tire. So it's a very interesting feature. And the last part, the fourth innovation in this product is the fact that this product is managed with an application which can help also to link with the company and have a follow-up of the usage of the tire. So I don't know that much today on this product. I'm super excited to have some talks with the designer at Michelin Studio to see how the new generation of designer are trying to reinvent the tire for the future. So it's a very nice and a very exciting project. Regarding Salomon, my company, I think this project is really linked to the user experience and design thinking process that we are now all more or less using. Post-it session, working with consumer interviews, and trying to find a way to have a more versatile garment, because when you're working in the sports goods industry, you can more or less create a pair of shorts or a pair of shoes for every terrain, every consumer. But in front of the new way that people would like to consume, have less good at home and extend the usage of the goods, we had a very interesting session with users and designers in the nature, where we discuss how can we increase the range of usage of our apparel wardrobe. So we create about 10 different pieces from underwear to outerwear that can be used for doing yoga, but also running, also Nordic skiing or biking. And all those garments have been built by sketches and tested toward consumers. And we also work on three-dimensional software to test our ideas toward consumers. The construction of those garments are really new for us, because we try to solve some hard points, difficult points that we have with all apparel today. That means we can go for lighter fabrics and very light, and sometimes a bit too light, and with problem of durability. For instance, the weak points on a jacket is most of the time the zipper, the opening, and that breaks or that damage the fabric around. So there is no more zipper. That was the intuition we had for this collection. Go for with simple technical button. Some cuts of the garment are very basic, I would say primitive, inspired by some antique construction coming from Indians or Inuits way to insulate and protect the body. So it's a very new approach to technical apparel for outdoor. And we are in the process to prototype after having these images. And I hope that for the exhibition, we'll have the consumer feedbacks and some nice piece to display.
Florian, could you conclude in 5 minutes just to have time for questions?
Okay, so here are some other products that I hope we will display. Some people that I know, some that I'm super happy to contact soon. A good interesting bifurcation is this mask from Decathlon that has been reused by some Italian designer to make some breathable mask and has been a great usage and a successful story during this lockdown. So a lot of very interesting way to change the way we are doing object today. Thank you for your attention, and I'm ready to answer to your questions. And I hope to see you in the exhibition next year in April.
Yes, thank you. This is a very good invitation. Okay, we have one question. As a designer point of view, what do you consider the most powerful evolution in the last years? Being 3D printing or design thinking widespread and or any other digital tools?
I can say that the design thinking is something that brought a lot of other players in the field of design and which creates a lot of interest and excitement around the job of the designer and enlarge the way we can collaborate in the company. And I think this is blurring the roles of the different player of the project, and it creates a very interesting situation. 3D printing, for sure, I think it's obvious that it's super important. It's been years that it has been invented, and we don't see it everywhere today, but it should become a new way to reduce and adapt all objects to the consumers. In the apparel world, it's not easy, maybe for the trimming aspect of the soft goods. In the footwear environment, my colleague, designer from the footwear department, are using a lot. But it's not that obvious. It didn't change that much today, or we didn't really put a step in this technology. The very big and interesting things is what is happening with seamless knitting in the apparel world. I would compare this to 3D printing in the hard design product. The 3D knitting has been massively used by Nike in the their free shoes, where this is a way to reduce the wastage, and this is a way to produce more comfortable and simpler footwear goods. And I hope that we can discuss about that during the exhibition, because some French companies are starting to use the same machinery. This is very technical and interesting machinery, those new seamless machine, seamless knitting.
Thank you, very interesting. Okay, next question. What about the necessity to go the ultra personalization for a designer? Does it change something in the process of a product design?
Ultra
customization, yeah.
Okay. Ultra customization, I think is a dream, is a dream we all have, but we, in the same time, I would say today we cannot realize that. And to survive, to create a good business, we need to go in another way, which will be for us versatility. That means timeless product, more durable, stronger construction. The fit of the apparel needs to be more inclusive. That means knitting for sure is very interesting in that situation because it adapts to different body shape. So I would say that it's more interesting today to have timeless product and versatile product where people can use to adapt to their life. So I mean also adaptability in the product and durability. So we have to reinvent the object to make them useful on a longer time period, reduce the things are on size, the tailoring stuff is really belonging to the past. And I think we have to go for more androgenic product, adaptable to any kind of gender, any kind of lifestyle, to make them useful for the future and to reduce the waste and reduce the misusage of stylish items.
Thank you. I like very much the last note on sustainability issues. I guess we should consider this anyhow. Last question maybe. What is the proportion of people in France sensitive to long duration sports, goods, sustainable and so on? What do you think?
The proportion is really tiny. We are a company working on a very small target of ultra trailer or very inspired skier who are looking for the next generation gear. But we are conscious that this target is moving, also because of global warming, where the snow is not here each winter. So we really have to skip on diversification of our business in trail running, for instance. That's how we started with these sports. But also today we are analyzing a lot of consumer behaviors in the city. How do they practice sports? For sure, we won't go immediately to indoor sports or fitness, stuff like this. We don't feel concerned about that. We are more digging into how can we apply outdoor function into urban environment in terms of mobility, for instance. On the scooter, you need more protection. On the e-bike also, you will need some kind of gears. So all those new topics coming from urban user are very inspiring for us today.
Many thanks. Okay, no further question and we are right on time. Many thanks, Florian. This was very interesting. So please to everybody visit the exhibition in April next year and do not hesitate to contact Florian for any further question. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.